talking of mobile and structured data, you know, back in 1980, we were working on computer diagnostics, the aim being to replace the intellect of the human of the physician because it's so limited. If I've got a stem cell professor who is almost entirely ignorant of 85% of other stem cell research in his own specialty area, heaven help us when it comes to anything else. What it means is that we're in the world of computer diagnostics, a complete rethink about the competence of a physician to diagnose and treat. What it means is that we're entering a new world, a world of cloud-based medicine, where most physicians will find themselves in the future overruled by a computer system. Why? Because, Daniel, you might be the world's, let's suppose, the world's greatest expert on recovery from severe burns, from 95% burns, you know, how to manage this person in such a situation. Now, if it's even humanly possible, you are the person who knows. But actually, 10, 20 years' time, we find a time when even someone as qualified as you might be in that area is now up before the courts because some particular person has died, we have an angry relative, and now we have an attorney attacking you because he's saying, and why didn't you follow the algorithm? And you say, well, I invented the algorithm. He says, yes, I know, but you're not always operating consistently with the algorithm that you created. He says, yes, but there's clinical judgment here. Yes, but the patient died. And so we have... And this becomes an irresistible force, I promise you. We will find that physicians, even though they are convinced the machine is wrong, will find themselves compelled to follow it. And just look at the speed at which this has happened. And just in the last few months, Ottawa Hospital has just ordered 3,000 iPads. The Mayo Clinic, 10,000 iPhones and 2,000 iPads. I promise you, these are not so the physician can communicate, but it's to control what they do. Is to make sure that they are aligned, the decision-making processes are consistent and coherent. And part of this, of course, is virtual medicine and connected with the other massive trend, which is to keep people out of hospital. We've talked about into the office. Yes, but actually that's not good enough. It's to bring them home. And that's really where medicine is going to be in the future. And if you want to know where the biggest explosion is going to be in terms of the volume of medtech, it's going to be in the home. I'm not saying in terms of turnover, because these devices will be cheap. It's all about trust. Our trust in a world where people no longer believe the medtech stories that you tell. In fact, let me prove it to you. If we look at this site here, TripAdvisor, who's used TripAdvisor in the last year? Okay, here's I want to benchmark your responses against another 50,000 people I've recently polled on this. Okay, here's a hotel in London, which is doing very well or very badly, depending on what you think. You type in here's the deal. The more the hotel advertises in the Financial Times, the more people just type in the name of the hotel into Google. And the more stories about rats they see. But here's the story. The real story is this. Where do you go first? You see, Google, the first thing you get when you type in the hotel name is a wonderful story about the hotel. The second is the most diabolical story about the same hotel. Rats, scorpions, and the rest. And then on the right-hand side, because the hotel logo can no longer be found on the listings, it has to hit back with a paid listing. Okay, so you've got three choices at one click. Which do you go for first? Put your hands up if you go for the honeymoon story. Put your hands up if you always go for the rats. Okay, now put your hands up if you go, you know neither of these are true. You go straight for the official marketing site because you know they tell the truth. And see, what you told me is something that's, joking aside, is actually really serious. If you remember nothing else today, remember this that you've shown me about yourselves. I'm just holding a mirror up to you. What you're telling me about yourselves is actually very typical of 95% of all audiences except Google itself. By the way, who wrote this one? This was the most beautiful hotel in the world. Correct. Actually, they have to be quite subtle about it. It's usually the nephew's girlfriend, because otherwise, you know, they get struck out by TripAdvisor. What about this one? Who wrote this? Competitor. Now, of course, you knew that. You knew that. You're sophisticated, intelligent, and extremely well-educated people, but you still went for the rats. See, the future is not about logic. The future is not about science. It's certainly not about technology or published papers. The future's about, as you've shown me very well, the future's about emotion. And what you show me is that even a sophisticated audience, and I do just the same, even though you knew that they're both a pack of lies, this one is written by the hotel, this one by a competitor, that even so, you would still prefer to believe the lies of a competitor. Perhaps it's so emotionally compelling. And you certainly wouldn't go near the official website. So what that tells us is that if we're going to tell the story about MedTech, yes, I believe, Lisa, because I know that you're here and I can breathe the same air as you. But actually, if it's your website, it isn't going to tell the story. The only thing that's going to tell the story is the YouTube video of the mother who breaks down in tears as she saw what happened to her daughter who had had her breast removed just like she'd had it because she's got the same gene, and she saw her 22-year-old have a perfectly reconstructed breast within the first 8 weeks. And that kind of story drives power, passion. And it's based on the truth. It has that ring of authenticity.